Now, electric cars, so what one, been on Trade Me a lot, but of course, they are expensive. Yes. But one of the good things about them, one of the pros, is the running cost.
That's right, but that has not been the experience of the driver in our next story. He's learnt that choosing the wrong type of electric vehicle for your needs can end up costing you dearly. Hato has the story.
I usually end up singing to myself.
Emile Volkenborg's commute is provincial, Cambridge to Otorohanga.
Every day?
Every day, yeah. 5 days a week.
50 kilometres in 45 minutes. About the same time it takes an Aucklander to travel suburb to suburb. And last year, Emile purchased a hybrid for just this journey. He's worked out.
50 kilometres out of my travel, out of 100, I'll be travelling on green gas.
Green gas. Electricity. That's the dream.
Reduce the carbon footprint and save a little bit of money, yeah.
Having fully charged his car at home, Emile's plug-in hybrid uses electricity for the first 25 k's before it runs out and flicks to petrol for the remaining 25.
Cut my petrol bill in half and, yeah, helps the environment as well at the same time.
Half petrol, half electricity. Emile's plan, plug in here in Otorohanga, recharge, and then when he returns from work, he'll be good to go home. But when Emile returned, his cunning plan was in tatters.
Oh, you're kidding me.
Emile estimated, based on how much electricity he'd need, that...
I was thinking, well, it's going to be no more than like $5.
It was not $5.
And so I was quite shocked to see that it was
$28. $28.60 for 25 kilometres of electric motoring.
Aren't they trying to get people to look after the planet? I mean...
The inconvenient truth is...
Oh, I'll give me 200 k's plus if I put petrol into my car, yeah.
$28 at the EV station equals 25 kilometres of motoring. $28 of petrol equals 200 kilometres.
A dollar a kilometre against 13 cents a kilometre.
It costs 10 times more to fill Emile's car with electricity.
That was a bit of a shock.
This wasn't Emile's EV dream, so he contacted Open Loop, who run the charger. They said...
A component of what you're paying is actually a parking fee, and you need to contact the council.
As well as paying for the power, crucially, Emile was paying 25 cents a minute for the park.
I'm annoyed because I don't see why I should have to pay a parking fee when I'm already paying to actually get the electricity in my car.
Especially in Otorohanga, where...
There's no parking meters anywhere, so it's only just here.
Emile did contact the Otorohanga District Council, who said not them, try the lines company. The electricity distribution company who owned the charger, they told Emile.
There is a time component per minute cost. We are not unique in this regard.
I was kind of left hanging still. That's why I contacted you guys.
So we went back to the lines company and invited them to come and talk to Emile. We'll get back to that meeting soon.
Hello, Emile. Nice to meet you.
But first... It's about now we should talk about AC/DC. Not that AC/DC. Electricity AC/DC. Emile's plug-in hybrid charges using AC. AC equals slow charge. Around 2 hours in Emile's case.
Yep.
And at 25 cents a minute for parking, an expensive bill at the charger. Electric-only vehicles use DC. DC equals fast charge. Around half an hour.
You guys tell me when.
Richard Edwards runs the EV and Beyond website. He says plug-in hybrids are good in certain circumstances.
Plug-in hybrid vehicles are fantastic for people who, say, live in the city or live in a town. They do most of their travel within town, and then they have needs for things like towing.
But not good if you want to travel and then recharge.
Ironically, if he'd had a full battery electric vehicle like I've got behind me, that return trip that he's talking about, he could do that every day for a week before he'd even need to plug in the car.
How do we compare to our neighbours across the ditch?
We are miles ahead. Australia is a long way behind New Zealand when it comes to particularly DC charging.
Yeah.
Back in Otorohanga, Emile had one burning question for the Lions Company CEO, Mike Fox.
So why do we have to pay 25 cents a minute to sit on this car park?
So the reason we have the 25 cent a minute piece is to incentivise people to spend the minimum amount of time they possibly can in the car park and free up this charger for the next people that are rolling through.
That seems reasonable, but Emile wasn't finished.
My thoughts are that, for me, that's quite high, the 25 cents a minute to park. because my car takes 2 hours to charge.
He's right, but Mark returns sir with an analogy about Emile's car.
Having fibre to your house, but a modem that can only deal with dial-up speed.
Emile had more.
People that have got a car that can't do fast charge can still charge here. Otherwise, why else would you have it?
He was onto something. Why provide AC charging if you don't recommend it?
Yeah, it is a good point, but again, that AC capability here is designed for, much, much higher capacity than this, so...
And it just seems I'm being disadvantaged because I've decided to buy a car like this that doesn't do fast charge.
Per minute, charging fees at EV stations are becoming less common. So Richard says shop around before dropping your dollars.
Try and plan whatever electric vehicle you're going to buy about predominantly charging at home. A car like that, this one behind me, costs $4 to $5 for me to top it up at home. It might cost me $15 or more to charge it when I'm out on the road.
At the moment, I'm running in petrol.
So Emile isn't charging his car in Otorohanga anymore.
Well, I'm using petrol, obviously, yeah.
Like all of us, he's hoping the future is cleaner, greener, and maybe cheaper.
What do I think I'll do? Well, I'll wait for the prices to come down.
Now, you think it's rough for Emile, of course. He's got to pay per minute at the charging station, but those things aren't cheap over. They're over $100,000 each. So the company's got to make their money back as well.
Oh, look, one of the keys is you've really got to do your research before you get the car, don't you? And speaking of that, the same applies to using the internet.
We're talking about the dangers of getting scammed by fake websites. Pippa here, she's been busy. She's rounded up some top tips to stop you getting caught out.